I did a tutorial today partnering with Makeup University on a Valentine's Day look. It was a giveaway she had going on for Revlon products as like foundation, bronzer, and everything that she sent me I used in this tutorial besides one product, but I will be filming it in another tutorial just because it didn't go with the Valentine's theme. So this look is based off of a Valentine's look, and like I said, if you guys want to see how I got it, then just keep on watching. I'm very excited to be partnering with somebody to do a tutorial on YouTube, so I will be leaving all her links to Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube down below in my product description. Also, with all the products that I used today, the descriptions will be down below. I hope you guys enjoy it. Make sure you give it a thumbs up, and make sure you subscribe so you get updates when I have more videos coming up. Thank you guys. Hey guys, so we're gonna start off with a nice light brown shade from this NYC palette and put it in our crease and blend it up a little. Now I'm just going to take a lighter color and apply it above the light brown I just applied to make sure it's all blended out and even. I want to have a nice base color because I am doing a smoky eye type of look. Now I'm going to take my Remy London Scandalous Eyes eyeshadow stick, and it is in the color gray. I'm going to apply this as my smoky eye color. Instead of using a black, I wanted to use a gray for a lighter type of smoky eye, but also still has that depth because we will be adding a little bit black to it later on. After you apply this in the shape that I am applying it, you are going to take a blending brush and just blend it out to give it that smoky effect. Now, like I said earlier, you can add more product, which I did, and now I'm just re-blending everything out. Make sure there is no harsh lines because that's not what you are going for. You're going for a soft, smoky eye. So just keep blending till you are satisfied. Now we're just taking that brown we started with earlier and blending it with the gray to make sure, like I said, there is no harsh lines. Now going in with my Remy London Scandalous Eyes in Sparkling White, and I'm going to apply this as my base on my eyelid, so that way the pink, since it is such a light pink, I want it to pop and the shimmer to come out more. So this right here will help as a good base to make that color pop. Now I am taking my eyeshadow brush and taking this pink from the NYC palette, and I'm going to apply it over the sparkling white that
I just applied, and we are going to apply it everywhere and blend it a little bit into the gray just so it transitions better instead of being solid color transition. Now I'm just simply blending it all out, making sure it's even and not harsh. And then I am going to go back with my Scandalous Eyes and fill in my tear duct, so that way when I apply the next pink in my tear duct, it will be brighter also, because this white is such a good base color. Now taking my Love and Halo palette, I am going to use the color Rose, and I am going to apply that over the white in my tear duct. Now going back into that palette, and I am going to take the champagne color and put it on my brow bone to blend out the brown and give it that nice highlight. Now I'm just going back in with a smaller concealer brush and taking that rose color we applied to our tear duct earlier and reapplying it just to brighten it up some more. Now I'm going to take my flat brush and my MAC Black Pigment, and I'm going to apply this on the outer of my eye just to give my eye a little bit more depth, but I still want to keep the gray for a nice soft look. Now I'm just going to go in with my blending brush and blend out the black and the gray together just so it has a nice soft look and there is no defined lines. Now I am taking my Wet n Wild black gel eyeliner and I'm using my flat brush and I'm going to start applying my eyeliner on my eyelid and creating my wing. To apply my mascara with Remy London Scandalous Eyes Extreme. Thank you.
Now I'm just gonna go in with my Carbon Black eyeliner and underline my waterlines just to give some more definition and create a catty eye type of look. Now I'm taking a makeup wipe and taking all the excess product off before I start my face. To start off, you need to moisturize your face with any type of lotion. Now I am taking my Wet n Wild corrective palette. I am taking the orange color and applying it underneath my eyes to get rid of the purple and blue. And also I am going to take the green from the palette and apply it to anywhere that my face has red. Now going in with my Remy London Last and Finish 25 Hour Protection Foundation. This is my first time trying this and I actually like this product. I am taking my beauty blender and I sprayed it with a setting spray and I'm just going to put dots and blend it all out slowly around my face for full coverage. Now I'm just going in and making sure that it's fully blended out. You can also use your beauty blender wet. I just prefer to use the setting spray because I like the way that it applies on my face with the setting spray instead of wet. Now I'm going in with my Maybelline Angel Winding Concealer Pen, my favorite of all. And I am going to highlight and conceal underneath my eyes, my nose, my Cupid's bow, and also a little bit on my forehead. And that's about it. Now I'm just going to go in and with my smaller beauty blender, and instead of wetting it, I'm using the setting spray once again, and I am just going to blend out this highlight. In with my Maybelline Shine Free Foundation Stick in the shade 330. Sorry, it's upside down. And I'm going to contour my face, my cheekbones, my nose, my forehead, and underneath my chin. Now taking my Wet n Wild brush, I am going to blend out my contour. Thank you.
Now taking my Revlon Nair Lily Naked in the shade Ivory, and I'm going to apply this to where I highlighted just to bake my face a little bit to get a little more coverage. Taking my Remy London Natural Bronzer in the shade 021, and I am going to apply this a little bit to my cheekbones, my forehead, and a little bit to the sides of my nose just to give it a little bit more contour. This is actually my second time wearing bronzer. I don't wear it a lot, but I am partnering with someone with this video and she sent me these products, so I'm giving it a try. I am taking my City Color blush in the shade Lotus. I love this blush, especially with this Valentine's Day look. I am going to apply it with my blush brush. I don't know where from, but as soon as I do, I will post it in the product description. This color is just awesome. It's just beautiful. I highly recommend it. Now taking my City Color Contour Effects On The Go palette, and I am going to use the highlighting shade in this palette, and I'm going to apply it to the upper cheekbones, the peak of my nose, my cupid's bow, and on my forehead. Now taking my Let's Get Naked by Remy London and my Nourish and Nude by Color Rich, I am going to take a concealer brush and apply the Nourish and Nude as a lip liner, and then I will take the Let's Get Naked by Remy London and apply it as a regular lipstick and blend them out. I love this Let's Get Naked by Remy London. It is such a pink, but such a nude pink. I just love it. It's my first time trying it. It is also another product that I got from being partnered with Makeup University. And I felt like the Nourish and Nude would just give my outer lips a more definition since the color was so peach. Now to finish off the whole entire look, I'm going to spray my face with setting spray, and that is it. Hope you guys enjoyed my video. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And also check out Makeup University's YouTube. Everything will be down in the product description for you guys. So don't forget to click and look.